is Reidsville Chamber of Commerce News and Views, a business resource show with a focus on enhancing the business environment through advocacy, mentoring, and education in an effort to promote economic growth. The Reidsville Chamber of Commerce is a membership organization in North Carolina, working on behalf of its members for the betterment of the community. With Chamber of Commerce News and Views you can use, here's Chamber President Diane Sawyer.
Hi, welcome to the Reidsville Chamber of Commerce News and Views show. I'm Diane Sawyer, and in today's episode, we have with us Drew Barefoot with Powell Barefoot Agency. Welcome to the show, Drew.
Welcome. Good to be here.
I'm glad you're here, and you've also brought a guest with you, so would you like to introduce her?
I would. I've got Brittne Stevens with me. She is married to one of my business partners, Blaise Stevens. We're working together, the three of us and a few others, on the Bikes for Kids program, and that's what we want to talk about today.
Well, that is why we are here today. That's exactly right. So we have been really excited about this program because I think that it is something that is needed and something that is really awesome. So tell us first why you wanted to do this program and how it fits into what you do with your business model and your work to give back in the community.
Well, Blaise and I have worked together for a number of years, and he kind of came or brought the idea up earlier last year. It just fit along with community support and helping children. We love to be able to do projects or raise money to help kids. We give a lot to charity for the high schools, the elementary schools. So the program got put together, and Brittne can expand on that a little bit about how it started. But we were just really, really excited to be a part of it and have really bought into to what it's doing and what it's for since we've gotten involved in it.
So you guys just celebrated an anniversary not that long ago.
We did.
And so talk to us a little bit about that, because I think that again, puts kind of an idea and an outlook of who you are. Like, you're not just somebody who's come along. Like, you guys have been in business for some time.
Yeah, but the two agencies, the Powell Agency and the Barefoot Agency, merged together in 1995. But the Powell Agency had been here since 1918, with Mr. and Ms. Powell getting that started early, way before all of us were here. When my dad merged with or bought Powell Agency in 95, I came in a year after that. Of course, since he's passed, I've been running the business, and we just continue on to try and do what we can for the community and be a part of it.
Well, I will say, I think that this is a direct result of something that I have seen happen with you. A lot of times when businesses change, partners leave, something happens, you know, like with your dad passing, a lot of times people kind of grow stagnant or don't do anything. And I think, if anything, like, it's pushed you to, like, make your dad proud and have a legacy. And you've just gotten so much more energetic and involved and wanting to do things and being involved in community services and giving back. And I feel like every time something comes up, like, you're like, hey, like, is that something I can be involved in or that we're interested in?
It.
And that's exciting to me. So to me, this is like headed in this direction of just showing truly how our businesses in Reidsville are community oriented and do care about the community and give back. So let's have Brittne tell us a little bit about how this program got started last year and where we are today.
Sure. So Bikes for Kids in general is a character and morale building program with a bike component. A lot of times you'll see, you know, folks giving kids bikes, and ours is really the bike is the vehicle, pun intended, but the character and morale building is really where you see that community involvement piece. And I think what made it stand apart when my husband and Drew kind of talked about it. So the program, it's for Title I or underserved third graders beginning. And the reason for that is third graders, it's really when school starts to be something different for them. They kind of transition from learning to read to reading to learn. And you see a lot of kids that sort of struggle with that. And then they're having their own thoughts about the construct of their world. And when you're dealing with that underserved population, you know, there can be sort of just the pain and suffering of what that looks like on the day to day. And so the character and morale building piece, I will say there's a book involved that they read. There's a lesson plan that the teachers incorporate. There's daily affirmations that they do. And the premise is You work hard, you be kind, you think big, you don't make excuses, and great things happen. And I think we can all stand behind that, especially because it does go right back to a rooted small community. And these are our people, right? And if ever you've met somebody who's, these are our people, is this guy. So I would say that in most of the situations throughout the country where Bikes for Kids has been done, there's a couple of schools picked up here and there based on people's connections. Mm-hmm. For us, we only know how to do things one way. And so we took on every school, every Title I and every Title I fringe school for a total of 13 mm-hmm. in the county. So not only did Drew testify for Reidsville, but we did all of Rockingham County and have partnered with the great folks with the school board to sort of work those logistics out and really make an impact. Now, it is a surprise for the kids. So they are under the impression that the premise of this lesson plan and the whole Bikes for Kids campaign is really about an essay contest. So they do the reading, they do the affirmations, they write essays and think that there's going to be three children selected as winners, that the prize is a bike. And so in the assemblies, which will be in first quarter, late first quarter, they actually find out that every kid is a winner because they worked hard and good things happened. And there's so much of a groundswell. You know, we've really enjoyed getting in front of, you know, the people who already know the integrity that Drew conducts his business with. Mm-hmm. But then this is something, you know, they're excited to talk to us, but then when we tell them about this, yeah. then they're excited to talk to other people and to help us, and it's been a really nice domino effect. So we're excited, I think, about what it's doing in terms of the connectivity and being galvanizing for, you know, our local businesses and business owners and just donors.
Exactly. A lot of the fundraising has been done by individuals. People taking on a challenge of a school. We had a local resident here that had a connection to one of the schools, called a ton of her friends, and raised the full amount for that school. Wow. So a lot, most of the donations, especially for the Reidsville area, have some, most, a lot have come from corporate or from businesses, but it, we were amazed at the amount of individuals or anonymous donors come get to the office in the afternoon, and there'd be two or three envelopes of $85 or $100 of people that are just wanting to give and be a part of it.
It doesn't matter how many times that I hear y'all talk about it, like from the minute, like I have just been in love with this program, and I've told a lot of people about it. I listen to you talk about it, and it's hard for me because I have a third grader, like, and that's my oldest child, and the things that you talk about, like going from reading, you know, learning to read to reading to learn, you see over every single day, like those struggles and those, the things, like their little minds are just, I mean, it's amazing. You're right, third grade is a huge transition year. Like we went from, oh, we were doing homework, and now we're doing homework for grades, and now we're getting tested for grades, and mm-hmm. it's a big transition. And I have a child, she's in the Spanish immersion program, so even more so, it's even that much harder and more of a commitment because they're doing things in both languages. And mm-hmm. so, you know, we've got math workbooks in both languages and you've got reading in both languages. And so, and I just see their little struggles and I think to myself, like, you know, it's already who's friends with who, who's not friends anymore,
oh, yes.
Who got elected to the student council. And I just told my husband, I was like, we're in the third grade. Like, are we really ready for this? Like, this is, you know, so it is such a crucial time. And I think sometimes third graders get left kind of behind, and you go from, oh, we're doing assessments, to I knew we had end of grade testing, but like they suddenly come out with, oh, beginning of the grade, middle of the grade, like mm-hmm. you know, trying to do all these benchmarks. And I feel like they test like every couple of weeks. Like it is, it's really insane. So the heart behind this particular age and this grade level for me is a big deal. So I thought that I was going to be okay, but just like listening to you talk about it and hearing a different person, I guess, talk about it, like it just really, for me, it's crucial because the Chamber has a history of being involved in these type programs. We did the Leader in Me program, mm-hmm. which is based on Stephen Covey's Seven Habits of Highly Effective People and trying to create leaders and let them build morale and character and leadership. And so I think anything that you do that that builds those things is so, so important. And some of these kids don't get that at home. Some of these kids aren't getting that on the weekends. Like, you know, and we talk about the backpack program and feeding the kids. Like, there's all these things that go in and play those factors. So, and I love to see a community and a business rally behind something like that. So I think this is amazing, and I can't wait. Like, I want to come to all the assemblies. I was already thinking. I was like, I was like, how am I going to fit all those into my calendar? Because
well,
I just want to be there.
We got the dates
there.
For those,
we
so
do.
We can give you the dates
Perfect.
And the times for those as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, I need to start blocking stuff.
We do. We want you to come, and we want the community to come. I would say we bit off a really big bite in this. It just didn't seem right, though, to do some schools and not all of them, right? We were not gonna add one more layer of the haves and the have-nots. Yep. And so in doing that, it has taken the village, and I'll be frank with you, we're not there yet in terms of having raised every single dollar. I mean, we've got people that have given $2 to $6,000. It's about a $6,000 cost to do each school. And so when we knew we had 10 that were, you know, very clearly Title I, and then we had three that were what I referred to earlier as the fringe schools. And so we didn't want to add to any of the strife that has been there with the friction of, you know, if you're clearly Title I, these funds are allocated and here's the help. And if you're not clearly Title I, you're just not clearly Title I, but that doesn't mean that the same needs and adversity aren't being faced. And so that's why we did choose to include them. We, at this point, are still actively fundraising and will be probably for another month just to get everything still in. There are people who have been specifically tied to one school in particular because maybe they had family members that went there or somebody works there or they have a child who's in school there. And then you just have people who say, my gosh, what a great program. Take my money and put it where it needs
to go.
And we love all of that and at any amount. And so the fact that, you know, Drew has worked so hard, you know, here in Reidsville specifically, and then on a greater, you know, county scale, and the fact that we get to be here today reaching more people and talking about it in such a candid way, we're hoping that that will kind of give us that last little push that we need to get across the finish line. Because if there's a way to take money, we can do it, right? You want to give it, we'll find a way to take it.
That's right.
And I think that we're all going to have so much to celebrate when we get there.
I agree. So is this something that's like a one-time project, or is this something that goes on and starts over for a new school year?
The hope and the dream is that this is every year. And that was why we picked this year, because we didn't want this class to get by without having it. So we kind of jumped into it late in the game, and it's been a rush and a lot of pushing, but we didn't want this third grade class to miss out.
So one of the things that I heard you say yesterday, you were talking about needs. Tell us what the needs still are. I mean, obviously there's fundraising needs and there's dollar needs, but I think there's some other needs too, correct?
Sure.
There are volunteer needs. We've got 900 plus bikes to put together. I'm hoping that it was explained to me correctly. The bikes, Huffy has given us a great deal on the bikes, a nice deal for the bike and the helmet. We haven't mentioned the helmets
yes.
a lot, but the helmet comes along with
safety
the,
first.
With
That's
the bicycle.
Right.
So the bikes will come partially put together, but we will need to put the finishing touches on. I'm guessing handlebars and seats.
Stickers.
It was explained to me that if you've never picked up a wrench before, it'll take you about 15 minutes.
Yeah.
If you've worked with a tool before, maybe 5 or 10 minutes per bike. So not a lot of time, but it can be another community building time or for businesses to bring their employees out. We've gotten just found out yesterday one of the sports organizations is going to come and help us. FCA is going to be a part of helping with that. So we're really excited to bring that part of it too, bring the community together to make this happen.
So, and I think those are some of the things that other people can help with. So we definitely need to make a bigger push for those dates and those times. Do you already have that set up as
we've
well?
We've got the assembly dates, but we don't have the bike put together dates.
Okay.
Big Apple and Ace have offered storage space. if we need it. I thought that was a really nice offer from Ross yesterday. But we don't, we're still working logistics out. We're still a month or almost 2 months out from that happening. Okay. So as soon as we get those dates, we'll let you know. We do have the assembly dates. Do you have those with you?
Yeah, they're the week of March 24th.
Awesome.
All at 9 a.m. They're going to be at each high school. So we're going to start in Rockingham or in Eden. Going to start in Eden.
And finish
in Reidsville. Mm-hmm. And so I'll get you the specific days for each high school. The reason for doing that there, Charles Perkins over at Central Office thought it'd be a great idea to involve at each high school. You can bring in the band, the cheerleaders, the football team, the basketball, the golf team, whoever wants mm-hmm. to be a part of it. And kind of do it in reverse. We found out through this process that the seniors, when they get their cap and gowns, go to the elementary schools and do a senior walk. So we're going to kind of mm-hmm. do that in reverse.
Cool.
And let them celebrate the kids and instead of the other way around.
Yeah. And I actually graduated from McMichael. And so when we're all sitting around the conference table and they start talking about the future Phoenix, be still my heart. I thought, my goodness, the whole Daggum County is going to see me ugly cry.
Yeah.
It's just, there's so many good things. And I've done a lot of nonprofit work. And, you know, my husband bought me a wine glass that says, stop me before I volunteer again. This particular initiative being so just at the core of it, a local embodiment. I mean, from the bikes being shipped here and assembled here and then hand delivered, you know, I mean, it doesn't get more local than that. And one of the things that we thought was really important is this is an entirely volunteer led program. So 100% of the donations that are given go directly to the bikes and the helmets and those costs. It's not admin or overhead and some of the fluff that you see in other things. So we are really excited to kind of get to that point, but I think there's going to be a lot of organic goodness in the gathering of the communities to put the bikes together and then to get them from point A to point B so that, you know, we can have the big reveal with the curtain opening and there being all the bikes there for the kids to sort of have that reaction to.
And that's going to work really well at the high schools too.
Exactly right.
You've got the larger auditorium and the curtains.
And all of that. Yeah. Well, I graduated from Moorhead, so I'm like, I have ties to everything but McMichael. I graduated from Moorhead here in Reidsville. My kid would be at Rockingham, so I mean,
well,
yeah, I'm going to be.
But you get that feeling.
Oh,
she's with McMichael,
yeah.
You're with Moorhead, I'm with Reidsville.
Yep.
You've got that.
It's
You've got
awesome.
A family that did Wentworth that's going to be a part of the Rockingham. I mean, it's just great to see people buying into having a connection to each one of those elementary schools or to the
high
schools.
Well, I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like, I want to be at all of them.
Yeah.
You know, I've got reasons to. And I imagine some of our dance people, we dance on the western side, so I imagine some of my dance girls who are in the third grade would be there. So, yeah, I mean, I want to be at all of them. Like, I'm really excited about it. So what else maybe that we haven't touched on would you want people to know about this program, about, you know, the foundation that started? Like, how did you get to this? Like, you heard about it. You know, now we've talked about it. We kind of talked about the different pieces. Is there anything we're missing that maybe you want to point out?
Well, one thing that I do feel like is important to sort of ask is that we need to invite everyone to sort of be conspiratorial in this because it is a secret. Mm-hmm. Now, we have sort of broken the mold because a lot of the times when this happens in other areas, it's, you know, three or four schools out of the whole county, and they're done sort of in little fits and starts. So it happens in a way that can be a little bit more covert. And we knew we needed our people, and we needed the rally cry. So we told all of the adults, especially the ones with the checkbooks.
Just hoping they're not telling the kids.
So, you know, not that we have lots of third graders who are plugging into a podcast or, you know, a stream, but as much as we can do to preserve the integrity of the surprise, I think, because that was one of the strategic reasons between doing four and bringing sort of the geographic
areas
together and then doing them all in the same week so that we could avoid kind of that trickle out of the disseminating of information. So we have sort of just taken the leap and put it in the paper and spread the word, hoping that third graders are so focused in their world of everything that you mentioned with your child that they're sort of oblivious.
They are.
And so we hope to, again, preserve that. But we do have the opportunity and to recognize the businesses and the donors that want recognition at these assemblies. And so anybody who, you know, has further questions or wants to support or be involved in whatever way, if we haven't already connected, you know, I know Drew and myself, we are fielding phone calls and emails and texts as often as we possibly can, just because anybody who wants to be a part of it in whatever way, we want to facilitate.
So is there anything that you want to add about the why or the how or, you know, any of that?
I'm just I'm just so bought into how this is going to affect these kids. I've seen the video. I've read the articles. I've seen the thank you notes from the kids and past programs. But to see it live, I think is going to be a little, I hate to say overwhelmed, but I think that's what it's going to be. I think
we're all,
whoever wasn't involved this year,
is gonna
once they see
involved.
It, I think we'll want to be involved next year at any level. There again, you know, there are so many ways you can do it. You can give money. You can help put bikes together. You can help us deliver bikes. You can be just at the assembly, being a part of it. So any way that you want to be involved, we're asking you to do that.
So for people who want to spread the word, or for people who want to tell others, because as you said, that's been a big part of it. So say somebody hears this or sees this, but is there somewhere to go on social media where there's already a post where it can be shared, where people are like, oh, I want to go share this and tell people about it, where it's already written well, where people can understand it?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, I will smile and nod at the written well, because I wrote it, so it's probably got some flaws. But there is a Facebook event that is public because it's an active fundraiser right now, and we have been sharing it. Lots of local folks have picked it up and shared it out. There is certainly the opportunity to reach out to us directly, and we can send links to make it easy so you don't have to hunt for it. The Bikes for Kids has a website that you can go on and look at the program, you know, nationwide, and get more details and information on. And hopefully we can provide to you guys some of this, some of the links, so that if there's a landing page or something that your listeners or viewers are familiar with, then it'll also be available through your mediums.
That, I think earlier in the year or late last year, we did, you sent out a blast with some links that were attached to it, and we can certainly do that again.
Yeah, I think it's time to probably have a resurgence of, and we have a huge Facebook following, so I was just thinking if there was a way, so we need to grab that event and maybe, because I was just thinking about creative, like maybe start out with a you know, don't tell the kids, but
yes, yeah.
Yes. Here's how you can help and kind of.
And I've been amazed at watching the donations on Facebook. I mean, you know, you see those, please donate to this every day, and this one has really, really grown up. We've had folks donate as far as Knoxville.
That's
and Georgia
awesome.
Way,
yeah.
So it's really interesting to see how it reaches out and touches folks.
Well, and if I might add too, from that, we've seen a lot of creativity where we've had folks that they didn't really have the ability to give, but they've been sort of the nexus point. They've gone to their church, to their pastor, and said, hey, is there any way that one Sunday we can put the offering to this? There, you know, and or they've gone in and they've done, you know, something creative at their workplace where people pay $5 to dress down and they culminate it and give it to us. Turks did a fundraiser in the restaurant that raised nearly $1,000. So there's all kinds of ways to just really activate things that are happening anyway and direct it towards this. And I think that's where, you know, we can help with that creativity and the logistics, or if, you know, you want a note written or a letter written, or you want a blurb for the bulletin at church, I'm your guy. I mean, I can help in any way, yeah. Because if people want to help, as I said, we want to facilitate that.
Well, I think that there are lots of ways that people can help, and it sounds like I think we probably need to do a last push for these are the ways, we're almost there, this is how we can hit the goal. Mm-hmm. So, and you know, Reidsville has really started to gather some attention locally, regionally, and then just for people who grew up here, who went to school here. So to your point of donations coming in from all over the place, I mean, we've got people, you know, in other countries, we've got people all over the place. And state championship football team, I mean, obviously that gets a lot of attention, but there are all these things that are happening on the economic development level and on the, you know, for us, like the things that we do with the visitor center. I mean, we're just starting to see this is a good place to retire, this is a good place to raise a family, this is, you know, so they're on a lot of different levels. Reidsville is doing things that gathers a lot of attention. So I think that quickly putting things out on social media, people are watching. Like people are looking, they're looking for ways to be involved, to give back to their hometown. So I think you're right. I think that there's probably some people out there still who would want to do donations on Facebook or that sort of thing.
And so they've all got a great connection because they all went to at least one of these elementary schools.
That's right. They had to have gone.
They've got a tie-in.
Yeah, I mean, even if they didn't go to high school, graduate from this high school, did a different program, went somewhere else, went to the School of the Arts, or, you know, whatever they might have done, they had to have gone to elementary school.
We all started somewhere at one of these 13.
In one of these schools. Absolutely. I cannot commend you enough for taking on the whole, like, I'm going to try to get it together. You know, you're right. There's a lot of haves and have-nots. There's a lot of these schools, this school, well, we can do this. And, you know, the kids don't see that. Like, the kids don't understand. They don't get that. I don't want them to get that. You know, I want them to feel like everybody is treated the same and has the same, you know, because the reasons that you do it, they're for so many different reasons. Whether they have a bike or not, whether they, you know, have the ability to be creative on their own and raise money doing chores or whatever, none of that really matters because that's not what it's about. So I just think that it's such a cool thing. So I'm really ecstatic about the fact that all the kids are being included.
Well, we appreciate you getting involved and getting behind us.
Yeah, well, and helping us say, gosh, to these kids, we are with you and we are for you, you know? And that can look like a bike. And it can look like an entire county doing everything they can just to make sure that these kids know.
Yeah, and there's a lot of people working hard to make sure that we're producing, you know, people, little people who are turning into big people who are, you know, good stewards of their citizenship here locally, but, you know, that they're leaders and that they're getting the skills that they need to, you know, get a great job. And, you know, there's so much. You know, we're in a transition because when we were in school, in my generation, there was so much focus on four-year schools and four-year degrees, and there wasn't another option. And I'm thankful to see, and I told my dad this, my parents were teenage parents, and so they worked really hard, but they weren't able to pay for our college. And my dad was like, well, I started something for your kids. And I said, I just want you to be clear that my kids may not go to a four-year school. My kids may go to a trade school. They may be an entrepreneur. They may open a business. They may need to go take business classes and certifications. Like, I don't know what the future holds for them, but to me it's wide open. You know, it's whatever that they want to do to be successful. And I just think that little things like this, these kids are going to remember this forever. I mean, they're going to remember that they went to this assembly and that everybody got a bike, and it's just going to be like the coolest thing ever. And I could not be more proud that it came from you and your business and, you know, what you're doing. You know, you have been a big, I'm looking at this, the sense of signs behind you, the home side, strong side, and I think about football, and I think about you and what a big fan of football you are, and I just, I mean, you're right, Brittne, like, he is that guy who says these are our people.
And
so I am tickled, and I think it's going to be awesome. So
he just builds a bigger table. Somebody needs a seat, he just builds a bigger table, and I think the world needs more of that.
I agree. Is there anything else you want to say about the business? Or, you know, I'd like for you to say, hey, like, this is who we are, where we're located.
Well, we're at 108 South Hill Street. You can come by anytime. We are fully lined. We've just expanded our number of companies, added SIA of North Carolina, and we're really excited about. So that's given us a lot more opportunity to serve in different companies, different lines of business. So please come by and visit us and let us see what we can do for you.
And in case people don't know, I don't know that we ever actually mentioned what that business is. I mean, we said the name
of it. It's insurance.
But it's insurance.
Any insurance needs that you have, please come by and see us. I got a great staff with Tracy, Diane, and Cynthia. We've expanded that, as you talked about earlier, or growing. Hopefully, even more to come. But right now, we're really excited to have the group that we've got.
And I think it just tells you, for anybody listening, Drew's not that guy. He's, you know, he when he's about a project or doing something, it's about that project. I mean, yeah, we couldn't even, right. I could barely get out of him. Now, you put him in a business setting and trying to.
Well, I can certainly talk about insurance,
I'm sure,
but I want to focus
can,
on this
but
program
I know this
today.
Is what you want to focus yeah. on, but I want people to know who you are and where to find
you. Well, I appreciate
you.
So if they appreciate that.
Want to physically give donations, you can come to Scale Street.
Yes, you can. And drop them off here if that's okay
yeah,
with you guys.
Yeah, absolutely.
Whatever's easiest for anyone. We want to make it as easy as possible for them to be a part of it. So.
Awesome. Well, is there anything else that you guys want to add?
Just thanks.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks so much. I've enjoyed being a part of it.
Oh, gosh.
You helping us in such a big way.
And hopefully everybody will be at the assemblies to see
it
come together.
Yeah. Well, I think there's going to be a lot of people who owe you a lot of thanks. You owe a lot of thanks when this is done. So, but anybody who's been involved in nonprofit work and volunteer work knows that that's, you know, not why you do it. So, it's obvious that you have a heart for that very thing, too. So, thank y'all for what you're doing. Thanks. It's important.
Thanks for having us.
All right, well, that's it for today's episode on the Reidsville Chamber of Commerce News and Views show. Stay tuned. Make sure that you check out our Facebook and Twitter. We do a weekly newsletter there that will keep you updated on all the events. And make sure you share the podcast and the show with everyone. Stay tuned. Go Team Reidsville.